Good morning, my dear students. Today, let's start the 8th chapter of English grammar, that is gender. As you can see on the first page, the definition is given and it is very easy. The definition is, gender tells us whether a noun represents a male, female or neither of the two. It's very simple and this we have done in class before, previous classes also. So let's quickly revise what are the different kinds of genders. As you can see, the first one is masculine, second one is feminine, third common and fourth one is neuter gender. Let's see the meaning of all four kinds of genders. The first one is what? A noun that refers to a male is said to be a masculine, it's said to be of masculine gender. If something is denoting, is indicating that it is of male kind, then you will be calling it what? You will be calling that it belongs to the category of masculine gender. Next one, a noun that refers to a female is said to be of feminine gender. Example, aunt is there, queen is there, hen is there and daughter. So when you read these words, you understand that they belong to the category of feminine gender. Third one, a noun that refers to both male and female is said to be of common gender. Sometimes what happens? Sometimes we are confused whether the person about whom we are talking is a male or female. For example, if I tell you that there is a teacher in the class. Now you do not know whether that teacher is a male or female. Same way, sometimes what happens? We talk collectively about certain group of people, where we are unable to identify whether that group of people are they male or female. So we categorize them all into common gender. Now fourth one, a noun that refers to a non-living thing which is neither male or female is said to be of neuter gender. Now sometimes what happens, let's take the example of books, tiffin box, pencil box. These are non-living things and we do not know whether they are male or female in nature. So grammar has done what? Grammar has categorized all these terms into neuter gender. So these non-living things about which we cannot identify what is their gender, whether they are male or female, so we put them into a category that is neuter gender. Now there are some useful tips of forming feminine of nouns. First, by adding E, double S. Second, by using an entirely different words. We'll be going through the various examples also. And by changing a word before or after. Now let's see certain examples how feminines of different nouns are formed. First, by adding E, double S. For example, they have given us few examples like author is authoress. Then next page we can see poet is poetess, princess princess. Sometimes the form is slightly changed before E double S is added. For example, sometimes what we are doing, sometimes we are making a change in the spelling also. If you notice here, tiger, spelling is G-E-R. When we are writing tigress, the spelling is becoming G-R-E-S-S. So you have to be quite careful because marks are given on spellings here. In case spelling is wrong, then the answer is totally wrong. God is goddess. God, single D. And when you are writing the feminine of it, it is becoming what? Double D. Same way as hunter, huntress, duke and duchess. A second one, by use of entirely different words. For example, masculine, bull is masculine and cow is feminine. You can see there is entirely a new word is there. Sir is what? Madam. King is what? Queen. So these are certain list of words where the feminine is formed by bringing about a change in the entire word. Father becomes mother. Cock becomes what? Hen. So you can learn the example and the examples are very simple. Third one, by changing a word before or after. By changing the prefix. Prefix we have done many a times and we know prefix means what? The word before. And suffix means what? The portion of the word coming afterwards. So sometimes what happened? We change the words which comes before. For example, here the masculine is cock sparrow and the feminine is hen sparrow. Bull calf, cow calf. So these are certain examples. learn them by heart. By changing the suffix, suffix means what? We are changing the other part, which is coming the end part, after part of the word. Dairyman is dairymate. Landlord is landlady. Milkman is milkmate. Fourth one, some exceptions. Some exceptions means what? Some unusual words. Bridegroom is bride. Viceroy is viceroyed. Widower is widow. Now fifth one, there are certain lists of words which we have taken from foreign language. Like the first one, this one is pronounced as bow, and the feminine is bill. Second one, czar, and the feminine is czarina. Signer, signora. Sultan, sultana. Some examples of common gender. Let's see. These are few list of words talking about common gender, where we are confused whether the person talking about the baby is he a boy or a girl. Bird, we do not know whether the bird we are seeing is a male or a female. Child is a male or a female. So these are certain common gender words where we often get confused whether the person talked about is a male or a female. Now let's talk about always remember points. These are very important and will help you to answer various questions also. Now, womanly qualities, for example, beauty, kindness and grace. These qualities are mainly talked about in girls. So these qualities, when talked about, we consider them what? We treat them as what? Feminine. Lifeless objects such as manly qualities like strength, harshness, courage, these all indicate what? These indicate manly qualities. So we treat them as what? Masculine. Now third point, all material nouns, abstract nouns, collective nouns are of neuter gender. So in case in any of the sentences, coming sentences, you find material noun is mentioned there, abstract noun, feelings are mentioned there, collective nouns are mentioned there, like flock is there, then a team is there. So what are these? These will be considered as neuter gender. Collective nouns, we have done a list, a team of player, remember, fleet. There are many other terms, bouquet, okay, bunch. These are what? These are neuter. These will be categorized into neuter gender. Now you have to do the exercise given in the chapter.